Good morning, everyone. Pastor Leif here, and this week we're talking about how to embrace, how to conquer the obstacles on the way of your calling. And for that, we're using the life of Mary Magdalene. The Word of God says in John 20, verse 1, that the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb early. It was still dark, and she saw that the stone had been taken away from the tomb. We talked about three things already. First one, don't let your past stop you. The case of Mary Magdalene, seven demons. We know that, you know, and that's how the enemy is. He tries to use your past and he keeps bringing it up. And that's how you got to fight it. You got to resist it. You got to stand your ground so you can move forward to the things that God has for you. Number two, don't be intimidated by darkness. She came early in the morning. It was still dark. John is very specific in the details he gives us in his book. There is always a greater meaning. So darkness pointing to the enemy, the devil at night. It's a lifestyle of hate, a lifestyle where you deviate, you get away from the light because you don't want your works to be exposed. So it's like walk in the light. You're never going to go wrong when you walk in the light. Number three, it was like how to fight the unbelief and the jealousy of others. In the case of Mary Magdalene, she goes back. She talks to the disciples. They didn't believe her. They run. They go to the tomb when they see it. And then they go back. But she stayed there. Now, number four, today I want to talk about this because I just saw this last week. It's one little word in the end that gives us that revelation, but we have to stop relating to people and even ourselves or even God after the flesh. And I'm going to explain what I mean by that. So I want us to see where she was during Jesus' ministry. Luke 8:3 says that she was part of a group of women that financed Jesus' ministry. She was providing for Jesus and for all his disciples. Luke 23:27 says that she was mourning and lamenting after Pontius Pilate sentenced Jesus. John 19:25 says that she stood by the cross as he was being crucified. Mark 15:47 says that she observed where he was laid in the tomb. So she kind of picked, she saw inside, she saw where he was. You know, Matthew 27:61 says that she was sitting on the opposite side of the tomb after they rolled the stone in front of the tomb. She was sitting there. And Mark 16:1 says that we see that she bought spices to anoint his dead body. I mean, she thought he was dead. That's why she went early in the morning on the first day of the week. But now when we continue on that scripture, John 20, verses 11 through 17, it says that, but Mary stood outside by the tomb weeping. And as she wept, And she stooped down and looked into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting, one at the head and the other at the feet, where the body of Jesus had lain. Then they said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "Because they have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." Now, when she had said this, she turned around. Remember, it was still dark, and saw Jesus standing there and did not know that it was Jesus. Beautiful scripture. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you seeking?" She, supposing to be the gardener, said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him, "Rabboni," which is to say, teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not cling." That's the word that I said. "Do not cling to me. Do not establish a connection in the flesh." Not in the sense, you know, like a sin, but do not connect with me this way. "Do not cling to me, for I have not ascended to my Father, but go and to my brethren and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father and my God and your God." So what does it mean? What do I mean by, you know, after the flesh? What does it mean? In 2 Corinthians, we see a crystal clear picture of this. 2 Corinthians 5:14-21 says, "For the love of Christ compels us, Because we judge thus that if one died for all, then all died. And he died for all that those who live should live no longer for themselves, but for him who died for them and rose again. I mean, right there we see, you know, what we always talk about, not being a fan, but a follower of Christ. It's like, he died for me, the least I can do is to live for him. Therefore, from now on, we regard, watch this, from now on, if we're following him, from now on, we regard no one, not even yourself, no one according, that word, it's like harmony, according to the flesh. Even though we have known Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him thus no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, so that should be the question today. Are you in Christ? Are you in Christ, which is the light? Are you in Christ? He is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, old things have become new. Now, all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ and has given us, and this is so amazing, because if you don't know what ministry, what is your calling, this right here is one thing that's for everybody in the body of Christ. He has given us, the church, the ministry of reconciliation. That is, that God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself, not imputing their trespasses to them, and has committed to us the word of reconciliation. Now watch this. Now then, we are ambassadors of Christ. Let me give you the definition of what it is to be an ambassador. An official envoy, especially a diplomatic agent of the highest rank accredited to a foreign government or a sovereign as the resident representative of his or her own government, or a sovereign or appointed for a special and often temporary diplomatic assignment. Yes, so we're not going to be here forever. It's an assignment. We're not from here. We're from above. Amen? So an authorized representative or a messenger. So again, that's what Jesus was telling to Mary Magdalene. This is what I have for your life. You are an ambassador, an unofficial representative. As though God were pleading through us, we implore you, on Christ's behalf, to be reconciled to God. For he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. So when we talk about then, now you see that when we talk about after the flesh, it means like that we discern them through your flesh. We see them only through their flesh, through their mistakes, to what they did, to the lifestyle, the way they used to be, or you see yourself only in that view of your past, yes, but now you are a new creation in Christ Jesus, so live like one, practice good, not evil, love the Lord, you know, and so it's not, the real you now is what? You are a new creation in Christ Jesus. Jesus said, nope, don't cling to me like that. I know your needs. I know what you've been through. I know you don't relate to a father or a son or a husband. Yes, but I want you to embrace that you are my ambassador. So that's my word for you today. Be encouraged. That's what God wants to do with his church. Can you imagine if everybody start living and just being an ambassador of Christ, living for him because he died for us? What would happen? What would happen if everyone, every church on the face of the earth that's preaching Jesus Christ and him crucified and raised from the dead, what would happen if everybody would embrace this reality? I'm sure this world would be turned upside down. Amen? So, Father, I pray today, encourage my brothers and sisters. I pray that this revelation, it would be part, that would be a reality to each one of us, that we are ambassadors, that we are called to the ministry of reconciliation. I pray, Lord God, and I plead the blood of Jesus, and I pray that you would bring us together, that you bring unity in the body of Christ, especially in the region we were in, where we are in. In the name of Jesus, give us a great day today in Jesus' name. Amen. Blessings. Pastor Lave, love you. Bye now.